Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to CP Digital. It's a new series that we launched last week as part of our initiative to keep the manufacturing and supply side communities engaged and connected during this kind of COVID stroke lockdown time. CP stands for the Cosmetic Ingredients and Packaging India Show. It's an exhibition and conference that was launched 3 years ago now by the Professional Beauty Group, which is a global exhibition and media house, one of the world's largest for the beauty and wellness community, which operates across Europe, South Africa, Middle East, and Asia. And CP is a new platform that was created actually from India. So it was created here from the group and to really look at the early part of the supply chain, so the finished product manufacturers and brands. And interestingly enough, we've now taken this initiative to the UK. So the UK this year is launching a CP conference and virtual exhibition in September. So it's a bit of reverse engineering. We created this show in India, and they're now taking it to the UK as part of our kind of global offering. We're really excited to again be having a great discussion, which is focusing on supporting the manufacturers out there with regards to getting back to normal and getting back to work in a safe environment. And the title of today's webinar is Unlocking Businesses, Precautions for Cosmetic Manufacturers as They Reopen. And I'm delighted we've got Kajal Anand and Dr. Prabodh Halde joining us as part of the discussion to keep you educated about the new norms you have to take care of. Introduction of Kajal, who doesn't really need much of an introduction because she's been around a few decades and has served the community well and is someone that's well known to everyone. I will still do the formalities. She's the chairperson and managing director of manufacturing and export company Devon Herbal Private Limited. She has over 35 years of experience in product know-how of color cosmetics and herbal Ayurvedic cosmetics. She's many accolades to her credit for her contribution to the industry. And to name a few include Iconic Brand of the Year 2019, Export Excellence Award, Best Entrepreneur Award, and she was recently featured in Forbes Online Magazine as Changemaker Ambassador for a UK finance company in India. As well as her role as founder of Devon Herbal, she was also the founder director of Herbal Cosmetic Cluster with existing cosmetic manufacturers and is currently the president of AICMA, the All India Cosmetic Manufacturers Association. She's a special invitee on the Committee of Administration of Chemexil. She's on the core panel of Bureau Indian Standards, part of the Government of India. She's the vice chairperson of AIMO, the All India Manufacturers Organization, and she's the national vice president of the Confederation of All India Traders, the ex-co-chairperson of the Committee of Industry and MSME, and a committee member of the Indian Merchant Chamber in Mumbai, IMC. It's a privilege to have Kajal on board, and she's going to be moderating a great discussion with Dr. Prabodh. So over to you, Kajal, ma'am.
Good afternoon, friends. I hope many people must have not had their lunch or, and they wouldn't go off to sleep. So we will keep our session very live. And as Vikas, thank you for the kind introduction. And as Vikas has said, that our topic for the day is unlocking business and how cosmetic manufacturers should take precautions. And we learned today the navigating guidelines for health and safety in the cosmetic manufacturing sector, analyze the standard operating procedures that need to be followed, understand the impact of guidelines and SOPs on transportation and labor. Friends, today being the 80th day of the COVID-19, and in this span of 80 days, nature has brought a drastic change in our entire working system, and badly hit by the COVID-19 slump, followed by social distancing and a nationwide lockdown, businesses are experiencing a major impacts. No matter how well established we are, we have to relook as to how to manage and operate the entire business plan. Friends, coming to saying that normally when we invite our invitees, we say, why do we listen to their biodatas and what they all have done in their career? friend, let us not forget here that when we invite such special people, it is to learn from the experiences, and we have various types of people attending the show. And when we share their experiences, you know, who knows who is going to pick up and what from it, you know. So here I go introducing to you a very dynamic, down-to-earth personality, Dr. Prabodh Halde, though young at age, but a legend in his work. Friends, do not miss on what all I'm saying about him. I'll quickly go through his brief introduction. He's an immediate past president of the Association of Food Scientists and Technologists of India, that is CFTRI Mysore, and an executive committee member of the PFNDAI and SEA India. He's a renowned food technologist with a well-rounded multidisciplinary experience. He's currently heading regulatory affairs in the R&D with Marico. He carries a huge passion to nurture the young entrepreneurs. A man with 25 years of strong industrial experience, having worked for Bakemans, ACC, and Coca-Cola India. Not a man to sit idle. He is on various boards and is a renowned trainer in area of food processing, food safety, and startup. He is also an advisory member for FASAI, Government of India, as a representative of food industry. One would be wondering what a man from food industry is doing with the cosmetic industry, right? No. Earlier, he was with the cosmetic division of Marico itself, and also on the panel of BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. And he is supporting and has mentored around 25 to 30 food startups, and through trusted group activities, he is supporting and mentoring over 200 startups and mentors over 100 students. He is on BOM studies for BMN, Khalsa, SNDT Polytechnic, ICT, Aurangabad, ICT, Kolhapur, KG Subhaya College. Ooh la la. He is an advisory board on SVT, SNDT, MIT, Pune, and IIFT Jaipur. He is a national resource person for FOSTECH program of FASAI, and so far supported over 250 startups directly and indirectly, and also helped over 400 students in shaping their career. He has delivered over 300 national and international seminars. He is the recipient of the Global Oil Food Safety Awards 2018 and Outstanding Regulatory Award 2018 by AIFPA India. He has been also awarded by MIT University Pune for Outstanding Personality Award 2019. That's how he is here with us. He got National Food Safety Eat Right Awards 2019 in profession by FASAI. He has started various innovative programs in AFST, namely Project Ashirwad, Project Avishkar, Project Power Talk, and Project Parampara. All these programs are now popular at national level, and he has written much appreciated books on retail industry. So these operate. He has also published 5 motivational books for students named Prabodhika. Recently, a 5th Prabodhika was blessed by His Excellence Sri Ramnath Kovind, President of India. He also works for Udaan Welfare Foundation for underprivileged section of the society. In COVID-19 conditions, he has trained over 40,000 students directly and indirectly, and industry people through his 19 webinars and videos. So these are few accolades, friends. Let's listen to our friend, philosopher and guide, Dr. Prabodh Halde. Over to you, Dr. Halde.
Yeah, thank you, Kajal ji, for such a nice introduction. Let me tell you, I work as a regulatory head for Marico, which I handle the cosmetic from last 10 years. So naturally, cosmetic is very much part of my job profile in regulatory and R&D. Now, without taking much, I will share my views. Can you see? Is okay?
Yeah, fine.
Kajal ji?
Yes. Go ahead.
Okay. I will take 30 minutes. So, and after that question answer. So 4 topics and then 30 minutes and plus 15 minutes of question answer.
Sorry, 1 minute, Dr. Prabodh, to interrupt. Let me tell the audience that this presentation will be sent to everybody. So you may kindly listen to what he is saying. Thank you, Dr. Carry on, please.
Yeah, this is shareable. The organizer will send this copy. And most importantly, you can also further share it. first would like to thanks to all those who are working for us. Because of them, we are inside and we are safe. Doctor, nurses, health and sanitary workers, police staff, government staff, essential service provider of pharma, beauty, hygiene, and food products, and all our elderly people who are working for us. Let me tell you, the presentation which I collected, and it is based on my own wisdom, but the inputs have been taken from the BIS document, FSSAI FOSTECH document, Ministry of Health document, Ministry of Home Affairs document for unlocking. Please refer to the original document for correctness. There might be some updates on time to time. The presentation is only for knowledge sharing purpose. I don't claim that you will get 100% authentic information because it is a dynamic information. So if there is any update and it is not included in my presentation, excuse me. Friends, cosmetic. Kajalji is one of the experts in the herbal cosmetic, color cosmetic and Indian traditional cosmetic. So let me tell you, when the Draupadi was working as in the Virat, King Virat, under one year of Agyatvasa, she was working as Sairandri, so beautician basically. And lot of references are coming, what kind of beauty products were there that time. And shampoo is also a Sanskrit name coming from champo. So champi jo kehte hai. So beauty is not new thing for us. Hygiene is not new thing for us. So just wanted to give, it is not a Western culture. It is India. Personal hygiene, India is number one. We may be doing a lot of wrong things on the socially, but our personal hygiene is amazingly clean. We take two times a bath or at least one time a bath. That's why we want to be keep clean, we want to be look beautiful, we want to be look healthy, and that is the India. Today we are undergoing through the big problem of this COVID. Every problem comes with an opportunity, and I personally believe MSME sector will be receiving 3 lakhs crore package. We need to decode that, how it will be utilized for our sectors. One virus has changed the color of the actually the entire universe from blue to red, and everybody is suffering. But I personally believe good innovation will come as an outcome of this. If today's India number of cases closely 3 lakhs, out of that 1.5 lakhs are recovered, unfortunately 8,000 death, and rest 1.5 lakhs which are 1.4 lakhs something which are under recovery, the success rate is more than 95%. So look at the spice belt, look at the coconut belt, look at the northeast. They are recovering very fast. What we understand from this, the traditional, the spices, and all those are helping to build up our immunity. The World War episodes, World War II episodes have given a lot of innovation. Same way, COVID will give a lot of innovation to this sector. Ball pen, photocopy, jet engine, canning technology has absolutely came as part of the World War II. Though during World War, lot of death occur, not good thing, but so many innovations came because of this crisis. You will come to know in next 6 to 7 months, so many innovative products in our industry also will see the market. But we need to change. Look at the companies, Group A and Group B. Group A companies were the leader of that particular area. Unfortunately, they are not a leader today. There must be something wrong. They could not do timely innovation. So our sector need to innovate fast to make the market and the consumer happy and delighted. As I was talking about, India safeguarded because of the immunity boosting doses which comes from this masala box. So many actives can be used in the personal care also naturally, and this is the way we have to also look at to the immunity boosting measures issued by the Ayush department, how we can utilize in the our personal care cosmetic sector. So Ayurvedic cosmetic would be the big arena which coming days we will see lot of products are coming in this area. Coconut oil is one of the great product, and I have actually shown how this coconut belt is recovering very fast. It is a absolutely a study required to do that. But Philippines have done the clinical on the virgin coconut oil in COVID, and naturally this oil in all the forms, topical application, inhaling, whatever, are good because of MCTs. Why I'm giving these inputs? Because these actives can be utilized in various formats. They are not only required in the food format. Same case with the turmeric, Alzheimer and turmeric. The reduction of the Alzheimer diseases in India is one of the responsible factor is a turmeric. And that also is very good active on the skin surface. China's loss of the export will be the India's gain. I'm just giving you the basic because this industry will grow. China's loss of the export will definitely increase the gain in the Indian subcontinent. One more area which we need to work, academia and industry, we need to work together because academia have a lot of research ability, industry has innovation and commercialization. So this marriage has to happen. I see a lot of MSMEs, a lot of our sectors, we need to work with the academicians, and that is new normal. Now, coming to my main topic of unlocking the SOPs. First thing, if somebody is asking, यार ये COVID कब जाने वाला है? COVID नहीं जाने वाला है. COVID नहीं जाने वाला है, इतने जल्दी नहीं जाने वाला है. कम होगी उसकी तीव्रता, इसका impact कम होगा, but it will not go completely for near future, maybe a year or so. We need to adopt to this new habit, and a people who are above 65 year, pregnant woman, and having some kind of ailments, I think we need to give them some kind of relaxation, and those people should not be asked to come for the work for near 1 or 2 months because they are very susceptible. If you see the total cases and death rate, the connection you will get to know, the people who are susceptible are getting. Finally, immunity is internal immunity, and those people are at the risk. So this is first thing. If you are unlocking your business, please ensure that a people who are at the risk, ask them not to come, work from the home, and give them some job which is not under exposure. This is very, very basic. Physical distancing is a new normal. Now there is a distance 1 meter or 2 meter, but I think physical distance of 1 meter is minimum is required. Thermal screening, all our plants needs to have that thermal screening machine without touching. You are actually able to see the temperature. That is a good indication whether the person is suffering, not suffering. Personal hygiene, the mask, gloves, these are new normal, and use of proper deep cleaning and sanitizing and disinfecting material. That is very, very important for coming days. And this is no negotiation on this. Arogya Setu app, I request all the people, please download Arogya Setu app, and if you and update that app, you will come to know how many people are around. I have coined the word responsibility for CBO. CBO is cosmetic business operator. So the people who are involved in the cosmetic businesses, the manufacturing units. Now, in the cosmetic businesses, the first is we need to conduct the awareness training for COVID, because it is very important to know. Some people are so confident, kuch nahi hota yaar, kya hone wala hai, main to young hu. Some people are very, very passive and they say, no, I will not come out of the home. Both are extreme. So first give the proper training of the what is actually the COVID-19, how is the personal hygiene, social distancing, how to wear the right mask. Some people are buying the N95 mask, which is basically cannot be used again and again, but they are wearing the same for every day. It is very risky. So which mask can be used and how to clean the mask, what is the safe handling, all those things are required. If any person having any kind of symptoms of fever, temperature, fatigue, cough, such employee should be asked to stay at home, and it is a self-discipline. There is no compulsion that everybody should come office irrespective of what you happen. Every business, which area you are located, these are the generic guidelines. every collector has issued some kind of guideline, have a local number of the police, local contact number, helpline number, one every factory, if not, depending on the number of people, isolation room, if some room can be converted into the isolation room, because in case if somebody is feeling actually not good during the office hours and he or she is expected to have some kind of infection, should able to isolate in a room and keep the proper record of health status, visitors, everything. During this time, we request, do not have any visitor to your office. You always can do everything on the phone or face chat or the WhatsApp call. Disposal of the used PPEs as per medical waste guidelines, very, very important, because finally what will happen if you end up your infection through this particular things will be really dangerous. So we need to understand, we are from the beauty and hygiene business. We should know that what kind of mask and gloves we are using, and the mask which we use, how to dispose those masks, how to sanitize those. Basically, for healthy people, a simple 3-ply cotton mask is enough. And that you clean that mask, sanitize that mask at the end of the day by proper washing with the kind of some sanitary agents and use it second day, or you have a pair of two, whatever. There are so many myths available through the WhatsApp universities and Google University, and that become confusing. First thing is that COVID-19 is recoverable disease. It is not something which once it comes, it will never go. So many people have got it and came out of healthy. So do not disclose the name of the employee if somebody is suffering. Do not flash it. Do not send the messages to 10 people. Be empathetic towards the people and his family. Make SOP covering emergency contact details and family members in the case a person has to go. Because once you become a COVID patient and the participants who are there today, somebody of your family or friend might have got this kind of infection. You must have seen that you have to follow the government rules. You will get the hospital which government has assigned to you. You cannot go yourself and get admitted. So on the personal hygiene, which is very, very important, hand wash for 20 seconds is a WHO guideline. Simple hand wash with any of the soap is enough, because actives from the soap and actually it is washes away all the viruses in the 20 second running water. Alcohol based sanitizers are great because they kills the viruses. Good respiratory hygiene, wear mask, frequent cleaning and disinfectant of the area which you touch, no close contact, physical distance is the new normal. These are the mantra of the personal hygiene. And keep your self hygiene good, your normal bathing, clothing and your own personal hygiene needs to be good. WHO has given the hand wash for 20 seconds with the 70% volume by volume alcohol. Face mask, how to cover the face mask. You can display the posters in your department and in your, because some people keep the mask and keep the nose open. Let me tell you friends, 90% of the infection in the COVID happens through the nose, because this particular infection goes to lungs. Whatever the infection goes from the mouth, actually our digestive enzymes or the acid which is present in our pancreas can actually kill that viruses. So most of the infection happens through the nose and eyes. Since you have a protective cover, it will not go, but nose is should not be kept open. It's very, very important. During the COVID time, if you are asking your employees to come, please ask them not to wear any jewelry, watches, because that gives the sweat and you keep touching to those 10 times. So keep it clean, keep it minimal. Your mobile phone, if it is allowed to work, best way, ask mobile phone not to allow into the work or the production room. But if it is, then because you are touching your mobile phone and it may have some kind of contamination, so stay away or sanitize it properly with the alcohol. Reporting of the illness is most important thing. Encourage worker to stay at home, and depending of the policy of the organization, you can give them that kind of guarantee that we will not deduct your salary if you report it that you are ill. But let's not create a havoc. And if the person comes, then tracing happens, and the entire your unit will get shut for 1 or 3 days. So that is the till the time of that proper cleaning, sanitation, and fumigation happens. So it is very important to have a trust. Discontinue those of biometric, fingerprint, sharing, belonging, gloves, jacket, common stationery, pen. So isolation not only in the distance but also the sitting. Even in the canteen, if you are having a food, please get your own food. You should have your own cooking heating mantles and ask them to sit separately. These are the new normal for next 1 year. Biometry and fingerprint can be discontinued and physical writing can be happened, or just looking is like from the distance you can activate whatever is the things comes. These are a few posters available on the Ministry of Health website. Please download. These are the generic posters, how to clean your hand, how to protect yourself, how to keep your all the mask and clean. Those posters you can display in your workplace. How to cover the mask, which mask to use, that these are also posters are there, what to do, what not to do. These are the beautiful posters, you can print it. These are available on free of cost. Also the gloves. Is the gloves is important to wear? If it is required, because you are touching something which you don't want to touch with the normal hand, gloves are important. But these gloves are not washable. These needs to be actually used and throw. You cannot use this again and again. Again and again, if you use it, it will have some kind of probability the contamination will carry. So if there is a mandatory things to have a gloves, decide which gloves, and depending on that gloves, you give that number of pairs to the people. Don't ask people to carry the gloves in the pocket, in the bag, because that gloves is carrying all the dirt, dust, and probably some kind of microbes. We don't want to spread through the gloves. So it's called as a physical distancing, and 1 meter and 2 meter, depending on the area, is required. Do not go close. Indian people are very warm, and we want to actually meet the people, friends. We may do the hugging with our own friends and shaking the hands. Please, new normal is now namaste. No shaking hands, no hugging, not going very close to the mouth and talking something in the slowly. We have to now talk openly only or on the phone. So the ratio is that 3 to 4 employees in area of 10 feet. Limit the number of people. If the drivers, cleaners are required, please see their history, where they are coming from. Keep the space, and you cannot stop the business. You have to continue the business, but take the proper precaution. Prohibit the sharing of lockers. Washrooms cleanings are very, very important. Use maximum online things for small, small things. Don't call your vendor. Ek product dikhana hai, vendor ko bula lo. Gone those days. Vendor also can. Bichara vendor ko bhi jyada takleef mat karo. Same way, you also don't get exposed. Cleaning and sanitation. Many people don't see one thing is this COVID virus is not the live virus. It is a dead one, and which is actually relying on the protective lipid coating. And that's why our soap solutions are very effective. And any soap solution or along with the water takes away that particular load of the virus. Alcohol based products are very good. Current ammonium disinfectants are also very good. Or chloride-based disinfectants are also very good. And the action is the same. But the time is very, very important. Not less than 20 seconds. These are the list of the some disinfectants like quaternary ammonium compounds, contact time of 5 to 10 minutes, peroxisate acids, 500 to 2000 ml per liter, as per the label, hypochlorite solutions, isopropanol, ethanol. These are given in as per the WHO and their strength and their contact time. And we can use that, and depending on their use. So what is required for your hand and what is required for the surfaces? Surfaces are basically for the hypochlorite solutions, chlorine solutions are effective. And for the body, isopropanol or ethanols are good. Some people, some very innovative people have done some kind of gate where they will spray the alcohol from the entry to the point. the WHO has also banned, government of India has also given some kind of advices. Such gates are dangerous. Do not spray alcohol on the body. Do not spray sodium hypochlorite on the body. Do not spray any kind of disinfectant on the body. It gives you false positive signal, I am safe, and then you keep touching everything. Number one, if it goes into the eyes, it is dangerous. Do not do this kind of shower bath or something. You only require to clean your hand. That's enough. Because the probability is that this hands touches to your nose is a probability of going inside. This virus is a dead virus. It doesn't have the own ability to flow from one end to other end. So unless the carrier comes and you become a carrier, or your hand become a carrier, or your pain become a carrier. So you need to be very effective. What kind of carrier I am allowing, or I am becoming a carrier. So cosmetic product establishment, the cleaning of the requirement with the soap and water and followed by disinfectant. So you need to know what is the cleaning, what is the disinfectant. Cleaning is general cleaning. Disinfectant means killing the viruses. Production area, store area, service area, waste disposal, office space, transport vehicle, all things need to have a proper scheduling of the cleaning. Hot water is also very good for the equipment cleaning. If you use the chlorine, it also do the corrosion. So you need to see that what kind of other cleaning chemicals can be used, or it should not get exposed more time. High touch points, we need to have whatever the high touch points in our factories, we need to have a twice killing cleaning to kill the microbes. And metallic surfaces like door, handle, security locks, you can use the alcohol also for instant cleaning where the water is not allowed. Toilet, washroom, these are the contact points where the probability of, because in one cosmetic factory, there would be only two or three toilets. You cannot have many toilets, so people will use multiple people will use same seat. So cleaning of that is very, very important. And the distancing is also important. And proper hygiene of that area is very, very important. For the perishable product and for the food contact surfaces, because finally you would have some kind of canteen also in your factory, or you will bring your own table. So you should know which are the chemicals are used. So where the disinfectant can be used and where the chemicals are used. So people are, I have seen that for vegetable which comes to home, people are using alcohol in it. I think this kind of things one should not do. Even Dettol is not required in this. Simple chlorine solution, hypochlorite solution is enough for proper contact time. But do not use any other disinfectants which are otherwise damaging your product. So these are some posters you can actually download. Simple tips and basic self-hygiene and self-discipline is very, very important in this. The difference between cleaning and disinfectant. Cleaning use the surface cleaning, but not killing all the microbes and viruses. Disinfectant gives you killing of the microbes. We require both. So people are mistaken that if only this hand sanitizer I directly apply on the hand, I will get clean and sanitized. No. First you have to, water is unavoidable. First you require a water and soap. Uske baad mein disinfectant, because that is a secondary. Primary is water and soap. These are the few posters you can have a look. Then sometime what can happen, you may have some kind of positive case, and that is a new normal. Do not have a stigma of having a positive case in your society, in your neighboring, in your factory. If the positive case is found, number one, today you cannot go and test yourself. Government will only give you the letter, the BMC, the state government, the local government, and then only you can get it tested. Testing is not in your hand. It requires a government nod and health particularly the doctor of the government doctor to recommend. Once it is found positive, first you have to notify to the local administration, the nearby local administration, if BMC is there and or the industry department is there, that such and such employee has happened and we have taken all the due course. They will come and they will guide you and recommend that the person who is having a symptom, even he should stay at home for 72 hours, because there the incubation time is that if something has to be opened up, that will come in the 72 hours. And there is no stigma that if somebody is suffering, it is bad. It is not like touching. Even if somebody has suffered in that area, need not to be other people will convert into the positive. It depends on your immunity. Let me tell you, it all depends on your immunity and the physical contact what we had with that person. So, in short, we need to live with the corona. Corona is not going to go away. We need to adopt with the changes. Self-discipline, hygiene is must. Product changes in our portfolio is necessity. We can start COVID safe unit concept certification. I already discussed with Kajal ma'am. China's loss is India's gain for export. India has a good domestic power, and don't worry, 2-3 months loss is nothing in the spread of the entire world. What has happened actually, jaan hai to jahan hai. Not to worry, we can always recover everything. Unlocking SOP is must. You need to have your own SOP. These are the guidelines, but what suits to your area, it is your area. So please make some simple 2-page SOPs. It is available on the Google. Make some SOPs, put this SOP, give the training to all your employees. Innovation is must. Herbal and Ayurvedic product will have a good gain. Good scope for startups. I see the good opportunity. MSMEs got 3 lakhs crore package. Health and wellness is a new normal. So India will have a good industrial revolution post-COVID, and we will be able to supply the entire world. Thank you for patient hearing. These are my credentials. If you want to ask, write, you can connect here. And thank you again for Kajal ji for giving opportunity, and Vikas ji. And I am ready to answer if any question is.
Well, thank you, Dr. Pramod, for giving us such a detailed presentation on various factors. The key takes, what I take from your presentation, is that one should have their own SOP suiting their units. Secondly, the export will be a big opportunity. We'll have to work more on touchless gadgets and maintain more of personal hygiene and social distancing. Doctor, when we say maintain social distancing, now there are many units who have very small units. How do they maintain that social distancing?
Okay, this is a question or this is advice?
It's a question. How would they, okay, small, how would they manage that?
See, these are the recommendation, Kajal ji, and naturally, even in the Mumbai, where the people are sleeping in the shift, I know that in Dharavi, the people sleep in the shift, 8-8 hours ka shift mein sote hai. I know the reality in the 10x10 room, not more than 3 people should be there, but now there are 6 family members, what they do? You have to maintain if social distancing is mandatory, but if it is not 1 meter and you have to work closely, then cover your nose, don't touch, and have your own, means like the appearance and your all the things under control, not touching somebody, not doing something like which will disturb others. You have to take those precautions. Rest, there is no any mantra. Nobody knows how this. See, if you remember when this virus came in January, people used to send the WhatsApp saying that it will never come to India. India ka temperature jyada hai, hum aise hai, hum waise hai. So we are also learning. Social distancing helps, but naturally, if there is no actually possibility, try to maintain as is possible. That is the only thing which I can say. And cover your nose. That is most important thing. Don't reuse your mask if it is N19. N19 masks are not supposed to be worn by normal people. That is only for the ICU patients and the doctors. For you and me, simple 3-ply mask is enough, which is a clean mask. Aur usko acche se dhoke use karo. Usme sweating ho jata hai, phir wahi mask do bar use hota hai. That is a dangerous thing. Whenever you go out and comes back, that mask should be changed. No, that same mask to be used for the whole day. These are the simple, simple tricks, and we have to learn like this only.
There is one question from our attendees, Mr. Ashok. He is asking, what are the other effective measures other than sanitizing aids which kill or prevent COVID?
Where? On the surface or on the hand? What?
Wherever.
So there are the list of the chemicals on the WHO. Alcohol is one, but there are herbal things are also there. Hot water is also enough, but then contact time and the exposure. Why the alcohol is recommended by all the government? Because it is a self evaporating thing. So you need not to again clean your hand. That's why alcohol use is very high. But this is a very smart question. There is an innovation required. Which other kind of sanitizer can come? WHO has given some avenues like herbal and all. Some people are using the black pepper paste and something neem. But I think more research is required, and we need to see how much log decrease in the exposure can happen. But this is a subject of research. As on date, alcohol has been found the most effective, and that is recommended by Government of India. But yes, as a researcher, I think there is a good scope in coming days. How many herbal things can come in this space?
Well, doctor, taking advantage of your you being here with us and your experience, I'm taking the audience a little away from the subject. What you're having done the SOPs or taken care of the SOPs in the units, what do you think would be the impact on the consumer behavior consumption patterns, wherein we need to bring the change in our manufacturing?
Yeah, very smart question. And Kajal ji, this is the most important thing today. We need to understand what is consumer is demanding today and what are the changes which happened in last, say, 90 days or 70, 80 days. We have gone online now. Everybody is using the phone for ordering the food or vegetable or ration. Now, consumer is looking for value addition. I don't want to go to doctor. If you can give some solution to safeguard his health, he or she is ready to pay more. So consumer mindset has become price sensitive, but depending on the value, consumer is ready to actually shell out more money also. So yesterday I was talking to you, if we come out with some solution from the beauty product towards hygiene product in the beauty space, that consumer will like. So those fine points where the consumer will be avoided to go to hospitals, and if the localized traditional way that consumer is now googling, the Google has actually given what are the Indians have watched in last 50 days. So they found that traditional recipes is one word which Google has found that Indians are watching. Otherwise the dirty pictures are all over, but first time the India is now going for the information googling rather than going for other things. So it is good trend. It shows that Indian people are looking for traditional knowledge and desi nukhe, and that converted with the scientific capsules. Naturally, people will ask. So these are the changes. We need to add value. We cannot say my product was doing well and that also will do continuously well. Hope so. But we need to bring those change which consumer is asking for. And the packaging also. Packaging also need to be changed now. People will go for smaller package. People will go for personalized package rather than shareable packages. At home also, people will say, ye mera dabba hai, wo tumhara dabba hai. You will see those changes. So we may have to change our small packaging, because the family pack concept may go, because people will go for small one and they will repeat it. Like toothpaste. Everybody has a toothbrush in house individually. Soap, beauty soap, some people are having individual, some people are using common. But post-COVID, look at the changes in the behavior. People will may go for, this is my soap, this is your soap. Don't touch my soap or whatever, that kind of thing. So this segmentation will happen. So you need to bring those solutions. And we need to observe again how the urban consumer is behaving and rural consumer is behaving. Because the market is really going slack. So buying proposition will not be a good. So price outlook and the actually we need to see how we can give in 5 rupees, 10 rupees something, because the rural consumption is going to increase because of the good monsoon, but their buying capacity as such is low. So how we can penetrate? So rural market, export market are the good opportunity for our sector, but we need to deliver what they are asking for.
So that means we have to go back to our Ayurveda days and look.
Not really, but yes, that knowledge in the capsule of the science, because Ayurveda means wo Ayurveda, what has happened? You don't ask questions. It works because somebody has told. So that will not work. The new millennium janta, the kids, they ask the reason why it works. You tell me why it works. So science has to be decoded. Today, everybody is using haldi in the milk form or in the water form because everybody knows haldi contains curcumin. Curcumin is known for this disease. You cannot just say ki ye le lo, ye kada le lo, or ye le lo, achha ho jayega. These people are very smart. They want answer. So our product also needs to deliver that commitment, whatever is committed through that product and experience by the individual. And again, we have a limitation. We are not a drug. So naturally, we will have only those, whatever is possible.
So people want instant results nowadays. So what do we do?
इंस्टेंट रिजल्ट चाहिए तो बॉलीवुड मूवी देख लो, इंस्टेंट रिजल्ट मिल जाएगा, 3 घंटे में सब कुछ मिल जाएगा. नो मैम, इंस्टेंट कुछ नहीं होता है.
आई होप पीपल अंडरस्टैंड दैट द थिंग्स डोंट हैपन इंस्टेंट, बट टुडेस जनरेशन वांट्स फटाफट होना चाहिए, अभी बोला और नेक्स्ट मोमेंट आना चाहिए, यू नो.
या वन मोर थिंग मैम, व्हेन यू आर एक्सपोर्टिंग, आई थिंक because the Ayurveda herbal, safety of the product will be the paramount important. Testing will come as, it will come with the cost. So our MSMEs, small sector people, they shy away for the testing, heavy metals. That is one of the biggest problem in the export of the cosmetic. Some colors are there. We need to be very careful because reject of the export can cost huge value. So we need to have, you cannot say hygiene, GMP, GHP is because of my size of the business. It is not. You need to adopt all the good practices for your business to showcase that your product is safe. So this investment you have to do in your personal hygiene, your company hygiene, your testing, all those things required to do.
Can you suggest some institute or an authentic institute where, you know, we can get everything at one place, one shop stop? We get a certificate for exports because in, as you rightly said, the importers are asking n number of certificates. So if we could devise one certificate where everything falls in place after being audited, you know, then if there, is there any institute as such?
Kajal ji, aisa kehte hai ki shodh jo hota hai, wo innovation comes with the crisis. Jitna bada crisis, utna innovation achha. Since I work for industry, oil industry, and we have to start our units in mid-March and or April first week because of the, we have to supply. Then we as a industry came out with this concept of safe COVID units. And we then hunted and we did some research and we found that through the Solvent Extraction Association, we decoded that entire policy of government in the tailor-made checklist. And what you required? You required one agency who is certifying agency, like any certifying agency. It is not appropriate to take the names, but DNV, LRQ, this kind of certifying agency. So we took that. We required one auditing agency, and this need to be different because it is otherwise conflict. Auditing cannot do the certification. They cannot do training because these are the three different things. So we got all this together and we did some kind of negotiation with those people, and they gave very good quote. If you are wishing, I can pass it to you. You further negotiate, they can come out with this. But these are the businesses which are also required, because if I'm exporting something and these exports need to have authenticated that I have produced from the safe unit and as per the guideline, like GMP certification, something like that. But these are the 4-step solution: training, auditing, closing of the reports, and then certification. So these are the 4 things. So these are the things which we negotiated at very cheap level. It's something around 15,000 per unit. So, but you can actually talk to those agency if they can further reduce. And there are might be many agencies working on this, but I know what we are negotiated with. I can pass you the.
I think with whom you have negotiated, if that you can share with us, would be great.
I will share. But you directly talk to them, and such kind of collaborative approach is required, because again, you will start working with them. Naturally, you will get 15-20 days. So now already we have done, we can pass you entire checklist also. And the good point about our checklist and cosmetic checklist will be close to 95% same, because M2, schedule M2, or kya hamara? So schedule M2 and GMP. So that will go as a COVID, plus we have to do the sanitation. That's it.
Do you think these certificates will be accepted internationally? because they have authentic.
See, basically these are the certifying body like ISO. Now, if the question is being asked whether this ISO is certified, yes, they are authenticated. Depending on the buyer, but something is always better than nothing. आज तो आपके पास कुछ नहीं है. But finally, the buyer is the king. If he says that this certificate, but we found that it is effective. Not only the buyer, but our modern chain people, they want certificate. कि क्या, what is that? Do you comply with this all the unlocking SOPs? बताओ किसने किया आपका? मैं self certify तो कर नहीं सकता हूँ. It is always beneficial. But yes, I agree with you. There is no such course. There is no such certificate. Our government has not appointed anybody so far. Till that time, we do our own. अगर कुछ government ने बोल दिया तो उसके पास चले जाएंगे.
Do you think that MSMEs should look to some alternate methods of approaching the market?
Definitely, ma'am. MSMEs can now approach differently. We need to keep our eyes open. We need to keep the new market open. Online is the good thing. Government has given lot of orders to the MSMEs. They have reserved some kind of things to only MSMEs. We need to see that. Also at MSME, before this meet, I was addressing to ICC, the Chamber of Commerce, for the MSMEs only. I am part of that. And we said that the government has given 3 lakhs crore to the MSMEs, but how to decode that 3 lakhs crore and how much transition will happen to actual MSMEs, we need to understand. So we can help them to navigate. So definitely, MSME should be a focus. And let me tell you, 1 crore investment in MSMEs generate 10 jobs. 1 crore investment in the other sectors only generate 1 job. What is good for India then? MSMEs. Because you give so many employment and youth require the employment today. Because India is a populated country. And post-COVID, government has to give the emphasis on MSMEs. And all our vendors are MSMEs here. We need to support them. We need to partner with them. On those days where you are asking your vendor to come and sit for 3 hours. No, you need to partner them. You need to value them. And so many innovation can happen through the MSMEs. So MSMEs can partner in the growth of the big industry. MSMEs can actually do their own business. They can do their own exports. Only the financial problems which MSME has, a financial problem, that can be overcome with the good innovation, good product mix, good services. And do not only depend on one or two product, because that is risky. If you have a good mix of product and services, then MSME, whatever happens, you can balance it out.
What do you think would be the impact on exports?
So, again, depending on the product mix, which exports and which country. But Japan government is asking some kind of beauty products to be chemical for beauty products, because their country is doing good actually cosmetic production, but the raw material they required to import from China, they want to shut and want to put in India. So export, I personally see, will have a good impact, positive impact, and in the beauty and chemical zone.
So
and nutraceutical also.
Sorry, what should be the focus areas to scale up the business?
Focus area will be again on the health and wellness, because the entire world is going towards that. Health, wellness in traditional way, in Ayurvedic way, in herbal way, in natural way. Now, consumer will start demanding, is my label is clean? Am I free of this? Am I free of that? Consumer will start demanding those. Those are the trends. And you have to cater to the consumer.
But the system of working from home is on, I mean, in this COVID times. So what do you see the future of cosmetics?
Future of?
Cosmetics. Because it's going to be rare people are going to use cosmetics, because they're going to sit at home, women sitting at home and working. So no application of lipsticks, no application of makeup. So what do you think would be the future?
I think it is all depend on how you look at. This glass is half empty, half full. I'm telling you, ma'am, so many cosmetics are being used today. When I'm taking a bath, without application of talcum powder, I don't feel like I've taken a bath. Deo is required, because so much of sweating. Deo is required. Why you say the cosmetic? Only lipstick or some other thing which are required for occasion or not. But our cosmetic is a huge range. There are so many products required. And we are so smart. you may come out with some makeup which is required, a bedroom makeup, required a drawing room makeup or something. So people are very innovative. People will come out with these needs also. If you are not going out, it doesn't mean that you don't require a cosmetic. You require for self-cleaning, self-feeling good. You require that. Unless I apply hair oil, I don't feel like I've taken a bath. So the consumption never gone down. It is only a pipeline. Products are never get lifted from the market. Let me tell you, per capita consumption of the cosmetic in India is anyway low, very low. So it cannot go down. Open the shop, people will queue it. All the products which we required for our personal cleanliness and beautifying will require. Only it will have a sensitive to the market price. People will be negotiating. Are, isme kya hai? Wo product itne ka hai, ye product itne ka hai. Now people will be more sensitive to the price. Unless you add value.
But what about the color cosmetics? Like now I'm sitting on Zoom, so I'm using a lipstick rather. Then suppose if I'm not going to office, why do I need to apply a lipstick or apply a foundation or anything?
I think this question is very interesting, and most of the time we don't do consumer insighting. My wife is there. She only applied a color cosmetic today on the hair. And I ask, you're not going out. He said, what you are saying? Morning walk ko to jaati hu na. Kya baat kar rahe ho? So, boss, main bata raha hu, India ka penetration for color cosmetic is how much? Illusa, ittusa. Kya yaar? Ye to only, I agree with you, high-end event of Bollywood, big event, shadi, ye band hone wale hai, abhi for next 6 months, bade-bade event. But day-to-day use, you may come out with touch-up, you may come out with, everybody will require it. Don't worry, ma'am, color cosmetic, aap apna abhi sale dekh lo, it will grow only. Because ye baal to banne wale aur white to hone wale.
Head dyes and all will have a good address, huh? Even if we are morning
walk. It will not, yeah, it will not degrow, it will grow.
Coming on to the online, do you think the MSMEs have a good reach there for online? Should they go on online or offline is better for them?
Now the business is online. There will be a online, and the wherever there is a crowd, people will not go. The mall will be the next 3 to 4 months. The mall business will have a problem. International airports are not opened up. So most of the business will go through the online or your Kirana shops. So you have to segregate how you will be putting. So GT, general trade and online. This will be the good segments.
Okay. So what would be the nitty-gritties, or you know, what would be the contracts to be signed with the online people with this? Any points on that? Any light on that?
Ma'am, sorry. This is the question out of syllabus. This is not my forte of the contract. So, sorry, but I think I don't know about that area. Okay. And the one thing COVID will teach you, everybody, COVID will teach. You need to be expert in the area, some area. Okay. Multitasking is good, but expertise is required. Expertise is required. You need to have an expert. Value addition is must. A company from MSMEs, who wants to do production, who wants to do marketing, I think now that will stop. If you are good at second party, third party, you do that. If you are good at marketing, you do that. Don't try to do the tabla and daga both, because you do not have money power to fight with the big brand. So better you do manufacturing. But if you have a good brand, though you are small, then do ask somebody to do the manufacturing for you. You yourself don't try to do both. Because finally, expertise is expertise. COVID has taught us that you will become expert, whatever the business wise or individual wise. Double balancing will be very, very difficult. Look at the time. I was actually absolutely on the time. So collaborative approach is the new mantra. Yes, Milan Mehta has said collaborative approach, absolutely.
So there is a question from one of the ladies in the audience named as Sheila Iyer. She wants to know, could you shed some light on shift in the distribution channels? For example, Marico, your company has reached out to consumers through hyper-local distribution during lockdown. Will it continue?
Ma'am, again, I am from R&D. I will restrict to my talk on the R&D. These are the talk beyond. Out of question syllabus. So I will say sorry to Sheila ma'am. I will connect with you, my marketing channel partner or the expert.
मैंने कहा ना हम आपका फायदा ले रहे हैं अभी
यार. अरे बिल्कुल ले लो, खुली किताबें ले लो, लेकिन जितना आएगा उतना ही बताऊंगा, उससे आगे तो नहीं बता पाऊंगा.
So I think we've had a very nice session with you, doctor. Thank you so much for enlightening us on so many points. And if there are any, I think I would request my audience, if they have got anything, to write to us so that we can convey to Dr. Prabodh and get all the information for all for the circulation.
Ma'am, I am again sharing my contacts. Anybody can touch base to me through the mail, through the WhatsApp or Instagram. I will be happy to give back whatever I have. And I always believe knowledge is for sharing, information is for confidential. But whatever is Google Baba can give, we always can share. And help each other grow together. That is a mantra COVID has taught us. Thank you.
It is a time for collaborations now. Thank you
once yes.
again. And we will, audience, we shall share his presentation. So please put in your emails or call on us. We can share that with you. So have a nice time. Stay safe and take care. See you in another webinar.
1 minute. I think Gautam Kumar has raised the hand. So we'll take a last question. Yes, Gautam ji.
Okay.
Ma'am, we can actually take one or two feedback if we are not closing it. One or two actually live. Let people ask.
Thank you so much, Dr. Prabodh and Kajal ma'am, for joining us today. Thank you so much.
Thank you.